Hello, YouTube. This is BonzaBingo88 bringing you episode one of what is one of my favorite games of recent memory, 7 Days to Die. Started playing this back on the PC and eventually got it for Xbox, and then I just bought this last night. Definitely one of my most favorite zombie games, survival games, you name it, open world. This game is awesome. Probably one of the most realistic ones as well. There's not really much of a story, as it's more like a Minecraft meets zombies, but looks better. There's a bit more to do. So we're going to get started here. We're going to craft a stone axe. So we are gathering pretty much anything and everything in sight. And how I like to play, and this is a recommendation that I have that has worked for me in the past, is don't venture out too far from your spawn point, because it'll bring zombies, they'll spawn zombies on you more than if you were just, you start walking out. So I would definitely recommend not venturing out too far. So now we just need one more stone and we can finish up this axe. You definitely want to keep an eye on, you got your stamina in the blue bar at the bottom left, you got your health bar in the red on the bottom left. Quests are up in the top right, you got your compass, day, and time in the top middle. And then after you collect materials, it'll tell you what you've collected and how much of that item that you've collected in the lower right. So let's go ahead and take a look here. So we're going to go over here to the map. And yeah, we started out way down here. Let's see how I can... No, that's not it. There we go. It's not going to let us actually pull it. There we go. That's as far as we're going to be able to get. So we spawned at the very south in the desert, currently around 70 degrees and dropping. Gives you elevation, gives you wind, gives you daytime, all that good stuff. So we're going to go over here to crafting. We don't have anything to craft yet. We just need one more stone, so we get the stone axe, and that's going to be the foundation of our crafting availability. So there we go. So we've gotten all that. We're going to pull up the inventory. We're going to go down here to stone axe, and we're going to craft one. And then we're going to fast move over to our first slot, and we can do this now. We can get wood a little bit faster. We can also upgrade stuff. So what we're going to do here, so the first day is we're going to fortify this house that we spawn next to, and that's going to be our home for at least the first night. It's going to be our home for the first night. So we're going to come over here. We got some wood now. And we are going to try and fix these things back to their former glory. It's going to help us out. These are going to be the best, easiest defenses just starting out. They're cheap. They're easy to maintain. Look at that. Look at that. It takes one piece of wood to upgrade it from slightly damaged to... I haven't heard that sound before. All right, so we're going to come over here, and we're going to fix this wood. So I like to do this thing where I only leave the top parts open, so that way I can still see outside. I'm going to take down everything around here and fix everything else up. So like, we're already level 2 in construction tools. That's going to help out because it's going to take less materials, and we're going to get a better quality item the more skills go up. So if it wasn't a window, I'm not going to worry about leaving it available. I'm going to still block everything up. And just go around here. And yep, there we go. There's some more pieces. Oh no, I did not want that. I'm gonna get some wood back from here. I did not want to upgrade that much. That's not needed. What? There we go. Alright. Pick up some more yucca fruit. That sounds like a pig. I have never seen an animal wander this close to my starting location in any playthrough I've ever had. Alright, so now we're going to go to our inventory and we're going to go over here to clothing. And we're going to get pants, shirt, hood, shoes, and gloves. So, start with the hood, pants, the shirt, the shoes, and the gloves. And then we're going to go over here to our person. And we're going to dress them all up. So as you can see, we got a receiver for a hunting rifle. Oh, we got two hunting rifle receivers. That's going to come into play later when I can start building weapons. I have to learn how to do that first. And I also got a piece for a revolver, or the 44 Magnum, so. Alright, our next quest is going to be, once it gets done, acknowledging the fact that we're wearing the clothing. I believe it's a wooden club. Yes, it is. And we've already gotten the wood for that. So we're going to come over here to basics, go down here to wooden club, and craft that. It'll take about 2 seconds. Bring that down here for a melee weapon. The next one, I believe, is bow and arrows. Yep. So we're going to need to gather some more stone. So we're going to go down here. Do not run into cactuses or cacti. They will hurt. So we're going to come down here. We're going to get some stone out of here. A recommendation that I learned from some videos that I watched in the past is you want to craft the arrows first before you craft the bow, because they kind of fall into the same category, weapons. So you craft a bunch of arrows, and then you craft the bow. That bow is going to be a higher quality because you gain the experience from crafting all the arrows. And that's the one thing I like about this game more than Ark, is it doesn't require as many materials to build. Arrows or anything like that nature. It's actually pretty simple. So we're going to break this down completely, 100%, because that's going to guarantee that we're going to be able to make quite a bit of arrows. Oh, no, now I got to craft a new stone axe. So go back over here to... Over here to stone axe. I'm going to craft another one. See, now it's level 2, so because we gained all those XP from building up the wood frames and building the first stone axe and the stone club, or wooden club, we got a more durable stone axe. Alright, so once we're down here, then we have to go find some bird's nests for feathers. This is the one thing I don't like, is that these things, if you're not looking down, you're probably going to walk right past them. But look at that, 22 arrow feathers there. We got another 19 here. Alright, so I stand corrected. So we're going to get us close over here. I'll explain about the green here in a second. That is the radioactive zone. You do not want to go over there because you're going to do this. See? You will take a hit. You will get sick. You will get hurt. Yeah, just don't go in the green area. So we're going to come in here just a little bit further. Look for some more bird's nests on the ground. Get some more yucca fruits. And we're gonna get some cactus. So yeah, we got a river over here to our west, so that's gonna be nice. So once we start crafting some glass jars, we'll be able to more fill them up, and then we'll cook them up. All right. So it looks like we found a much better melee weapon. Make sure, yeah, okay. So now we're gonna go back up here and we're gonna head inside. We're gonna scavenge throughout the house. Yeah, you you are going to come across stuff that they're not going to have anything in them, so don't get just, you know, upset. It happens. It just means a scavenger came before us. Actually, I am going to see what this is right here. It looks like a bag. This will be the furthest that I go away from the house for right now. Sports bag, and we got a jar of water. Let's see if it's pure. Looks like I added to my inventory already. So yeah, so this is bottled water. It's fresh. It's safe to drink. You can actually get sick and get diseases by drinking unpurified water. Can't believe I haven't checked this yet. So you always want to purify everything before you drink it. Does that mean, or did I hear a chicken? I'm not quite sure. Alright. So, I'm going to come up here, and I'm going to fix this door. There we go. I'm going to do that. And we'll go and block this one up, too. And, can I do this, too? I'll do it from the inside. Alright. Alright, there we go. That's going to help us out. I'm not going to worry about this. I'm going to block that up, too. Make sure that's all blocked up. You'll see why I'm going to do this here in a second. Oh. There we go. If we can go ahead and go get some water from the river. There we go. That's what we need, one of those. Searching cupboards. You always want to be searching everything around you. Look, now we can get even more water. We're going to go ahead and get that out of here. Here we're going to utilize all this table space here. All right, so we're going to come into the bathroom. There we found some unpurified water that we're going to go ahead and put in the campfire. There's that. Now we're going to fix this. Now we need more wood. Oh great. A zombie has spawned. So we're going to take this opportunity here to craft some arrows. And we're going to maximize that. 6. Because we need more wood. So we're going to go out here, we're going to chop down this tree in front, get ourselves some more wood. And keep an eye on him. These zombies, they are sneaky sneaky. So every little thing you do in this game will give you XP to some degree. So make sure you're staying over there. So what is your guys' favorite zombie apocalypse movie and or video game? My favorite one is probably going to be Land of the Dead. Favorite video game, I'm going to say probably Left 4 Dead. Especially when you got three friends all doing co-op with you. That game is very fun. Now, in this game, do not stay under a tree while it's falling. It will cause you damage. Now, I know first, that is a pig. So real quick, we're going here. Now we're going to make our arrows. And we can make a lot of arrows. So we're going to go ahead and make 55 of them, because we're only going to use feathers for arrows. And then we're also going to make the wooden bow after the fact. I'm only going to make one of those. But we are going to drop this. No, we don't want to do that. There we go. I'm going to scrap that. Now, this is my first time playing it on PS4, so it's going to take a little bit for me to realize the controls and how they're different from the Xbox and PC, so please forgive that. Alright, so while that's crafting, we're going to come up here to this door that's unlocked. We're going to reinforce that. let's go ahead and oh, I can't believe I missed this bird nest right up against the house. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and take care of this zombie because we don't want him to. So yeah, so if you hit R3, you're gonna crouch down, you're gonna be undetected. And you could actually get a sneak bonus if you were able to land a strike on him. So you just wanna watch. Actually, you know what? We're gonna do this instead. There we go. So in other words, we got level 52 or 52 durable. I figure out how to. Is it circle? Yep, circle is to reload. There we go. So we got a 2x sneak damage bonus. Is he dead? Yep, he's dead. Alright, cool. So he didn't have anything on him. So then you guys turn into these gore blocks. You're going to want to get rid of these because it's going to cause more zombies to come by. So as you can see, we are now clear. Oh, we got one up there. One over there. So we're going to go back inside real quick, and we're going to reinforce the house a little bit more. Let's see, what do we need here? You know what? We're going to go ahead and break this down to get this last quest out of the way before we move on to the next one. So we're going to do this. We're going to craft 3 wood frames. Asking us to. Nope, I am not. There we go, 3. We're going to craft 3. Need space, there you go, get rid of that. Then we're going to take these 3 wood frames here, switch them with the glue. Then we're going to place 1 and upgrade 1. We're going to do the same up here. Go ahead and put these ones right here. That's the other thing I like about this game is that it has structural integrity, so if you don't have anything supporting something, it will fall down, and then you'll lose all the material. Which will force you to be smart about what you're doing. Alright. Yeah, so like I was saying, is I like Land of the Dead. It's one of my favorite zombie movies. It's also Left 4 Dead is also one of my favorite, if not my most favorite, zombie game. Most of you guys might ask why I'm doing this on the second floor, and that's because they have these things called spider zombies. They can actually crawl up the building, and they can actually get through where normal zombies can't. So. And I'm just doing this because I don't want one of these things to accidentally like break and then I just fall through, so. I don't think it can get through the one space, so we're going to go ahead and leave that one as is. And we're going to do this. And I'm also a little slight case OCD, so I like having things completed. So. So we'll leave this one here for me to shoot out of. So this one, we'll leave that one up here. I'm gonna come over here, finish up these, just because I'm pretty sure they can climb up here. So. Right. There we go. And also, all this stuff is actually giving me level ups and everything, so. And I don't need them breaking down this weak stuff to get up here on the Horde Knight, so. So this game is called 7 Days to Die because there is a Horde Knight every 7 days. So you're gonna have zombies that'll sprint, you have zombies that'll spawn, they'll go into like what they call feral mode, which means they'll know exactly where you are, even through walls. So that's something to keep in mind. So we're gonna go ahead and craft a bedroll here. And I'm going to keep it from going down on the bottom floor by putting it up here. Once it finishes crafting. Yeah, we'll go and put it up here actually. There we go. Oh, we're getting trophies left and right because we're just starting out. So now the next one is to craft a fireplace or a campfire, which is, if you remember a couple minutes ago, this is why I decided to clear this area out. So here's that. So we're going to craft it. 2, 1, boom. Craft that there. Then we can come over here and we're going to take one of these. I'm going to put it up. Nope. Okay, so put it in. Did it put it in there? No, it did not. So we're gonna come up here. This is how you're gonna be able to cook stuff. So we're actually gonna run back upstairs. Over here to this campfire. We're gonna put the second one in here. And then we're gonna cut this in half. And it's gonna give us... Nope, sorry, wrong area. And give us about a minute 20 worth of fuel for the fire. And then we're coming down here and we'll do the same thing. And we're gonna start out with taking those two things of bottled murky water right here. Over here. Gonna take two of them. It's gonna take about 40 seconds. Make sure you turn this on and then hit cook. And then every 20 seconds there is going to be a clean, fresh bottle of water sitting here in the output. So in the time that I have left, I'm going to head out over here to the west. First things first, come over here, get the 8 bottles of water right here, get my club out for defense, and I'm going to go right over here to the river, and I'm going to collect some water to cook overnight, and that'll give me plenty of water to make sure that I don't die of dehydration. So come over here, and hit left trigger, or L2, now you have 8 bottles of murky water. And then I can climb back up here. So we have about 1 hour left until the sun goes down. And that's when the zombies really come out and they're going to be in full force. So for a series standpoint, I'm playing this like The Walking Dead, where the zombies don't really run unless it's going to be on the 7th day. So, nope. We have a neighbor coming to say hello. Question is, where is he at? I know I heard him. I'm gonna get out over here. I hear him walking. Oh. There he is, he's way up there. That's a loud zombie. Yeah. can't believe that's gonna happen. I got infected on the first night because. So that means on day two, we're definitely gonna have to go out and find some antibiotics. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and head inside. We're going to close our door. We're gonna pull this up, and we're going to go over here to our player, and we're gonna find out that in 2 hours, 28 minutes, and 52 seconds, my character will die of infection. So, now the question is, I'm not sure if that's 2.5 hours game time. No, it's up to 2.5 hours real time. So, we would need a jar of honey, antibiotics, or herbal antibiotics to heal. So we're going to go out looking for this. Oh, actually, what's this? That's beer. Unless we can find a jar of honey out in the world. So, that is going to do it for episode 1. It looks like I'll be doing one day is an episode. So I will see you guys all in episode 2. Have a good night. Take it easy. If you like this series, leave me a like. Subscribe if you're new. And once again, discussion time. Favorite zombie movie, favorite zombie game. I'll see you guys in episode 2. Have a good one.